Hello, I'm Jeremy Ford, and today I'm going to be painting a seascape in watercolour. I've already got my drawing on pre-stretched paper, so I'm ready to go. First of all, mix a colour for the sky, and I need plenty of this. I don't want to run out or risk running out, and I want two other colours, a cloud colour and a shadow colour. And the first one will be ultramarine, plenty of it. So that's ultramarine. And then I'll have another one, raw sienna. And then a shadow colour, which will be very pale grey. And that's ultramarine with a small amount of cadmium red. Tiny amount of raw sienna in that. I'm going to start with the number 16 round brush. On the top left-hand side here, just paint a little corner of the sky. Just take that down a little bit, and then very quickly soften the edge of that with a damp brush. A damp brush, not a wet brush. If I used a wet brush, then it could shoot up into the blue and cause a cauliflower or blooming. Then, keeping well away from the blue, wet the paper where the cloud is going. Drop in the weak raw sienna. And underneath that, drop in the shadow colour. You might just need to encourage it to mingle a little bit to begin with. If it doesn't soften, just move it around a little bit. Back to the blue. And pick up the other side of the cloud. So that cloud goes off the edge of the picture. I don't mind leaving little bits of white paper here and there. They add to the roughness, the blustery effect. Same thing again, with a damp brush, just soften the edge. Soften the edge here and there. It doesn't matter if you don't soften everywhere, because some clouds have hard edges, some clouds have soft edges. And then dampen the inside of the cloud. Drop in the weak raw sienna, and then the cloud, the shadow colour. Encourage that to mingle a little bit. And now I'll carry on this sky with the number 10 brush over on the other side now. And I'll let that cloud run into the blue that I'm just putting on. Just soften here a little bit. Once you start this kind of thing, you can't stop. Soften it here and there. So now I'm going to be thinking about making the next bank of clouds lower down. Then dampen inside the cloud, being careful not to touch the wet blue or the drying blue. Drop in some grey. Soften it a bit. More blue now. Soften some of the edges. It doesn't have to be really perfectly neat. It's supposed to be a blustery day, so the clouds are scudding across the sky. Some of them have got soft edges, some of them have got hard edges, it doesn't matter. And now as I come lower down, the clouds will get smaller and smaller, and they'll make the blue a little bit weaker. because the blue is paler towards the horizon. So underneath those clouds, pushing and shoving the brush, and generally speaking, keeping the underside of the clouds fairly flattish. Soften some of those hard edges with a damp brush, not a wet brush. And you need to do that quickly, otherwise you can end up with too much of a hard line. Little bits of hard lines and hard edges here and there are okay. Smaller, thinner clouds. So that helps us get a sense of distance. The clouds look smaller, further away, and the colours are a bit weaker. And let that dry. I'd like to put in some background hills now. So using a number 8 brush, I'm going to mix very pale green with cadmium yellow and a small amount of ultramarine. Very, very pale colour. And a blue-grey. So I'll take some of my sky colour and some of the grey from before and add that grey to the sky colour. So I've got a bluer grey and a pale green. And so working on the dry paper, nice and wet, plenty of paint on the brush. And as carefully as you can along that line, so far along, and then carry on with the green. Introduce the pale green so that they merge, so it goes gently from the blue-grey into the green. It's not an obvious green, it's a pale, distant colour. If I made this too dark, it would bring the background too close. Just put a bit more grey in it there, and take that up to the edge of the rocks, and let that dry. Now the hills are dry, I want to mix some sea colour, and I can use what's left of the background hills by adding a touch of Windsor blue-green shade to it and a tiny amount of the green from the background hills as well. It's a blue that's going towards green. And using short horizontal brush strokes, leave a few little bits of white here and there, tiny little bits of white for the foam in the distance. Tiny little bits of white. And coming closer into the foreground, the little bits of white can be a little bit bigger. And now here, I want to use clean water on the edge of the cliffs. Just here, I'm going to put water in that area so that when I put the sea colour up to that, it just softens, it melts into that. Now I'm dragging the brush so that it hits and misses the paper, and this should create an impression of foam. Lower down, add a little bit more ultramarine to the sea colour in this area. And go around the figures, in between the figures, and then carry on the other side with that pale colour. Dragging the brush, very pale greenish blue. And that needs to dry now before I can do any more to it.